the latest property data, really interesting as well. Property Track shows Sydney and Melbourne's house price growth is slowing down.
Yes, so this report is a monthly report. It came out this morning because it is the 1st of August today. And basically it shows that property price growth in both major cities of Sydney and Melbourne is starting to taper off. So you can see in July, Sydney house prices increased 0.63%. But in August, they were up only half that rate at 0.28%. Melbourne, it's a similar sort of story, up almost 0.24% in July, only just creeping ahead 0.01% in August. So this is really a sign, Laura, of interest rates starting to have an impact on the property market, but also it's the fact that there's more stock coming onto the market as well. So buyers have more choice at the moment. They don't feel forced into buying a certain property because there's more homes available. So those are two of the reasons why we're starting to see property prices slow down, and they're probably going to stay at this sort of level until the cash rate starts to lower. As soon as the cash rate lowers, sellers are going to get more confidence, and we're probably going to see property prices go up even more.